There came a problem. The Ammonites. Ammonites are the children of Lot. Ammonites were born from the lineage of Lot. And Jephthah and his family, they are born from the lineage of Abraham. Bible says they started claiming, when you guys, you are moving from Egypt during the powerful deliverance of God, you stole our rod and you took our rod and you want that rod back. And they came to the elders of Israel. And who are the elders of Israel? The brothers of Jephthah. Jephthah was born in the house of power, in the house of authority, in the house where there was dominion, in the house that was defined as the kingdom house. This is where Jephthah is born. Ammonites were cousins to Israelites. These cousins were mean cousins. Watch your family. I say, watch who? Watch your family. The people who will compete with you to the teeth are your family. Because they know you. They can size you. They can size. And they wanted to size the children of the house of Israel. And Bible says, they are mightier and stronger than the Israelites. The Ammonites were mightier and stronger than Israelites. But even then, because Jephthah, even when he's kicked out of the home and he's in the ladder of Tob, he was still doing good. Because as long as you are a child of God, doing good, you don't struggle. Doing good is who you are. You didn't hear what I said? Doing good as a child of God is who you are. You should never get weary of doing good. So whenever they would try to attack, Jephthah could come and help, and he would go away like nothing happened. Because he knew he was born to do good. He was born to defend. He was born to defend the cause of God. He is born to serve the Lord. He is born to do the will of God. That was clear in the heart of Jephthah. And I want to declare it to you. Any child of God who is in the house today, I want you to know you are born to do good. You are born to defend the cause of God. You are born to defend the gospel. You are born to defend the work of God. You are born to stand in the gap for the work of God. You don't need to be called here, come and serve. You are born to serve. It is the reason why you exist. You don't have to be begged to come and serve. And when you give God your time, it's like you are doing God a favor. Do you know God does not even need to talk? He just needs to press something. You are gone. You are out of here. Quickly. Then we all come crying and saying, he's gone. Nothing we can do. Because God's case has no appeal. You didn't hear what I said.
So, you are born to serve. Jephthah knew,
because these precious people, the people of God, they know their identity. God is their. Anything that does not look like God should never be anywhere near you.
I say anything that does not look like God should never be anywhere near you. Jephthah knew he is born to serve. And even when this Ammonite would attack, without telling these other fellows that kicked him out, because men of God has no revenge in them. Yeah, this is hard gospel.
Men of God has no revenge in their heart. If you see your enemy struggling, God still expects you to go and help your enemy from the struggle. Because he's born and he has given birth to you and he has given you his power that you may become a deliverer like the way he is. Tell your neighbor you are born to be a deliverer. Oh, come on, tell them you are born to be a deliverer. I know they're asking themselves, who have I delivered? ever since I've been born. God has given us as deliverers. Praise the name of the Lord. So this guy called Jephthah, whenever these folks are struggling and they kicked him away, they don't like him. And whenever they are struggling, he always goes because he's full of the wisdom. He's full of the power of God. He knows how to deal with his stuff. God exists. You know, Mungu akikuingia ndani ujinga unatoka. When God is in fullness, God's fullness is in you. Foolishness goes out. If you have to go, wisdom comes in. Ukiona mtu akitoa ujinga, hana Mungu akutosha. Hata kwa nyumba ukiona mzee anasugua kila siku ni ujinga, mambo ambayo haina msingi, anapigana nayo ni kama mtoto. Hajapata Mungu akutosha. If you see, let me interpret because of our sisters and our brothers who are here who don't understand that Greek language. If you see a man always troubling, always being very petty, repeating on things that are silly, just know they don't have God, enough of God in them. I'm a mama, kila wakati, very fussy, little things, speaking on things. Before you sleep, analeta mambo, ingine sijui ya mwaka gani. They don't have enough of Jesus. Lay hands on them and tell them, receive the power of the deliverer. Be delivered, my sister. Or be delivered, my brother. Come on, mzee anakusumbua analeta nyokonyoko. Tell him, brother, be delivered in Jesus' name. Lay hands on them. We got the power. It is in us. Victory is on our side. We are on the winning side. We are on the side of God. Our children, when they struggle, don't struggle with them. Don't start. Stop crying and start praying. And when you get a chance, lay hands on them. Tell them, my sons, you are blessed. You are fast, but not last. Even if they are bringing peace and ease and health home, that is not the approach. And you are there just in the wilderness, but they are going to pass. They are passing through. Don't be scared of those D's. Don't be scared of those F's. Don't be scared of those E's. As long as you are standing in the word of God, as long as you are faithful to the word of God, God is ever faithful. He is ever faithful. Don't worry, you are only passing through that. You are, Bible says, you are above but not beneath. That is your portion. You are only passing through the wilderness. Wealth of God belongs to you. Cattle in the thousand hills are yours. God is still working something behind the scenes. Hallelujah. When they were kicking him out and rolling him, and the boy was going crying, carrying his bags with him, he looked rejected. But let me tell you, he was the your source. He was the your power. He was the your victory. He was the your joy. It was him who was to restore peace again in Israel. Because Bible says when they were attacked, they looked around and they wondered, who can help us? Because now it is becoming overwhelming, even to your enemies. Very soon it will be overwhelming. They are going to come looking for you because you are the answer. They are going to come in repentance. They talked about you. They talked about your family. They talked about your children. But they are coming back repenting and saying, we are sorry. We said it, but we said it wrongly. We are led by the devil because we belong to him then. But you have repented. And they will come asking for, apologizing and asking for forgiveness. The worst thing that you can do is to fail to forgive them. And when you forgive, don't just say, I forgive you. Do something. Go visit them. Go eat with them. Do another something. That will be like a charcoal on top of the yard. A hot coal on top of the yard. That's what the Bible says. If they take the outer clothes, give them even the tunic. If they slap you this side, tell them even this one is available for you to slap. somebody insults you, never insult them back. Can you hear me? If somebody gossip about you, don't go ask them. Let me teach you wisdom. For you, when you start rising up, you know they when you start rising up, they see you rising up. And that's why they throw stones on
Jephthah. After they are attacked now, they wondered, who can deliver us? They looked, because people before they come to you, they look.
They look what?
They look. They went on the year list. They would tick that one, cancel that one. Tick that one, cancel that one. They would be left probably with a list of 1,000 people. Then they should shortlist them. Then another probably 500. Then they should shortlist another 500. Then they will be left with 250. Then from 250 again, a list of 150. Then from 150 probably 100. They shortlisted them. Only one man was left in that list. And that one man, after serious vetting, very, very serious and thoughtful vetting of a whole nation, was Jephthah. A man who is kicked out of a house become a national leader. Ka chojo, kama Everidi. We had batteries that are called Everidi. Whenever you put it on that radio, the radio just go on. You turn it on. Everidi. Ka ready, ka Everidi. Why? Because you never know your day. You don't know your day, the day of your visitation. Because a day came and it became the day of Jephthah, the day of visitation. He saw elders of Israel knocking by his door. This time around, they are not coming to give him counsel. They are coming to seek counsel from him. They are coming to tell him, we have looked around. The only one man who can deliver us, the only one man who can deliver Israel, it is you. We know we kicked you out. We know we reject you. We rejected you. We are sorry. We want you to come and become our national leader. When he was leaving, he was less than anything on that land. But when he's coming up, people are singing behind him. People are singing, have found a new leader. People are singing, victory has come home again. Yes. Don't worry when they are kicking you. They'll come for you. And they won't come for you now with that attitude. They'll come clapping. They'll come saluting. They'll come dancing. They'll come wanting to identify with you. Because of him. If I were you, I would appreciate it. Listen, people of God. When they looked for him, you know, when he was leaving, the bags were there and his head was down. He is demanding and they are saying, yes, sir, we are ready to do. Because they have seen dust. Wewe ukiondolewa mahali huko, watu wataona vumbi. If you are kicked out of where you are, because they don't know you are the watchman of that city. They don't know you are the watchman of that house. They don't know what you do. Praise the name of the Lord. But wait, the Lord is going to manifest you. I said the Lord is going to manifest you. You are a powerhouse. As long as you are aligning your life and you are walking in accordance to this word. When they saw Jephthah come again, remember he went out when his head was down. This time around he's coming back. Oh, can you tell your neighbor, I'm coming back? Look at them and tell them, I'm coming back. Yes, he worked a miracle in the life of this man. He was in the lot of top in rejection. But when he was coming back, he was a powerhouse. And I'm here to tell you, because you are a powerhouse, start living like a powerhouse. Start thinking like a powerhouse. Start walking like a powerhouse. Start doing things like a powerhouse. Don't do things like a reject. I say, don't do things like a reject. Do things like you own everything that God owns.
The message, you are coming. That is the time you should walk like a people. You have to learn to command your mornings, your day, your hour, your time. You know, why the devil has been happening on you is because you have to overcome the wilderness for you to be put in the palace. You
no problem. How will you help me get out of mine? If you don't know how to deal with your own problems, how would you help me pull out from mine? Because the palace is a place of authority, an authority over people. So you have to be put through the wilderness so that you may know how to deal with the wilderness, so that when you are put in the palace, people who are coming out of the wilderness or people who are in the wilderness, you are able to deal with them. Because you know how it feels to be in the wilderness. Jesus is the only rightful person who can deal with us. Even God cannot deal with us.
Can you hear me now? I say, going forward from the death of Jesus, God does not deal with us. We are left with Jesus. Why? Because Jesus came here and he tested what we go through. And God said, now, the very rightful person who can deal with you in the palace is God. Who is Jesus? Why? Because Jesus has been through and he knows what you go through when you're on earth. He walked in the wilderness. He knows how it feels when one is trapped. He knows how it feels when somebody spit on your face. It is the worst degradation that you can go through.